Can you hear me? Or should I hold it? Alright. We are here today to congratulate only our best graduates. From 6th to 12th grade, they sit here, smiling so hard from ear to ear. They've worked their butts off all year long. They stayed up so late sometimes they slept past dawn. But nonetheless, the homework was done and turned in. The tests and quizzes were passed with no problem. MashaAllah wa al-fabu. May all of you one day go to Duke. Or better yet, say Tuna College, where you can increase your Islamic knowledge. The one that you already have planted within, but can grow so much deeper if you think. Think above the influence of the fast life and cars. Forget all the worthless talk of is there life on Mars. Remember the one who made you in the best form, the one who created you to worship even in your dorm. Wallahi, I am no one, and do not deserve this honor. But just give me your attention, and soon I'll be your goner. Okay, so now that I have your attention, I have a confession to make. I am not the byproduct of Islamic school. I was not privileged enough to be. Looking back at my time during school, I would barely consider myself being Muslim. I was in so many ways different than everybody else, but trying so hard to fit in that I completely lost my self-identity and eventually lost myself. It wasn't until a chain of a certain events that occurred to me during the summer of 2008 that I realized what it really meant to be Muslim. Islam is not just a list of do's and don'ts. Islam is more than just halal and haram. Islam is a way of life. And what better way to start this life than at a school that instills the correct ideology into your child's mind and heart? It's been said that knowledge is power, but no one ever specified what kind. Islamic knowledge is the most essential type a person can have. It goes beyond the stimulation of the neurons in your brain, but delves further into the neurons of the heart. It's a physical change you feel when you gain the right kind of knowledge. It's like a deep tissue massage to your heart, literally softening it up. Now imagine an environment where such Islamic knowledge is combined with the education needed to excel your child for the future. The education needed to gain Muslims the status in all aspects of professionalism, not just medical and engineering, but even the arts, journalism, fitness, and nutrition. Charlotte Islamic Academy's focus is exactly that, developing your child not through the usual curriculum, but rather with a strong emphasis on building a true Islamic identity within each student. They don't just learn how to solve for X and what's an exothermic reaction. They also memorize Quran, learn Hadith, and gain a profound outlook on Islamic history. The dichotomy is essential to the constant balance we strive for daily in feeding both our body and soul. And although I have not experienced this firsthand, I have seen it in my sister Shireen, who graduated 2 years ago from CIA, and my brother Rayyan, who has been going here since he's been in pre-K, mashallah. But this isn't a fundraiser dinner, so I'll stop talking about how great the school is. This is a graduation, a day to recognize and commend the students who have worked so hard to be here today, to be part of the history of students who move on only to bigger and better things. We are all so proud of your accomplishments, and we ask you to keep up the good work and keep it up for the right reasons. Not so that you can get straight A's and get the full ride to the school of your choice. Not that you can be a lawyer, doctor, or somebody with a PhD, although all of those are great. But to do it for the sake of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the love of the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And lastly, do it for the true power that Islam upholds. In the second to last ayah of Surah Al-Mujadila, Allah says, كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لِأَقْلِبَنَّ أَنَا وَرُسْلِي إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَوِيٌّ عَزِيزٌ. Allah has decreed, verily, it is I and my messenger who shall be victorious. Verily, Allah is all-powerful, almighty. Here we see that Allah clearly states that Islam will be victorious.
Inshallah.
It has been written by the all-powerful and mighty himself. So no matter what negative attention Islam keeps getting, and no matter how many people abuse it or make fun of it, one day it will prevail. So remember that. And whenever you feel like a weird one washing your feet in the public bathroom, or not drinking till sunset in the hot Arabic sun, there is no doubt that Islam counts the most. We can all sit here and be moved by a few words on a piece of paper for an instantaneous second. Or we can all come together right now and make a promise that we will take what we have heard about this school, about these students, about these teachers, and commit to their future betterment. That we commit to volunteer our time when we can to assist the teachers as need be, and that we commit our money to fund the school so that the next generation can excel as much as their public school peers, and that we commit our talent to start a sports program here. These are the things that will keep us going. These are the things that will keep the blood pumping through the veins of this building. Let's keep this Islamic spirit alive and live to support the Charlotte Islamic Academy in every way. And now I'd like to end my speech with yet another poem. Jazakumullah for your time. I hope you have enjoyed all my rhymes. It's been a pleasure standing here, though my turn back every year. I know there was a lot that I said, but please just remember one thing in your head. If you are ever sad or alone, please just remember one thing. There's only one call to make on the phone. Turn to Allah in every way. Turn to Allah 5 times a day. He is the one who made you see, hear, and speak. So use these gifts for good and don't be weak. Stand up for what you believe in every day. Spread all you know like the sun's rays. And as for you, Ms. Muslima, don't ever be scared to be a mutahajjiba. Protect your jewels from the evil outside, just like a seashell holds its pearl and hides. And as for you, Mr. Muslim, grow that beard like a true mu'min. But don't ever think that that's enough, because God will definitely catch your bluff. Be sincere with all your deeds, for Allah knows it all and has no need. So congratulations to all of you, mashallah. My speech is almost over, so holla! And for the last line or two, I just gotta say, being here has definitely made my day. So update your Facebook status and tell the whole world I'm a CIA graduate, haven't you heard?
But this school affected her life in a bad way.